Hey guys, Odin and I are out for a impromptu adventure. It is in the low 20s. It's the 25th of February, I want to say, and the 26th of Sunday. Just decided to pack up some stuff real quick. I don't know if you can see the sign behind me there. We're at the Debar Pond area. We're going to go try to find this old great camp called the Debar Pond Lodge. It's all shut down, but it's been vandalized recently. It was in the papers, and I wanted to get a look at it before something happens. I don't know if the state's going to keep it up, or I know some locals are trying to keep it up. So we're going to see if we can find it. We're just going to walk down this trail here and see what we see. So you're welcome to come along with us.
Just come to this gate not far from the parking lot. No motorized vehicles. Odin's already halfway up the road. So hopefully the lodge is down this way. I don't think it's signed or anything like that. So we're just, this may end up just being a short walk on a freezing cold day. I'm also testing out some gear. A lot of stuff I've had lying around for a while that I haven't ever really used. So I don't know what it is, all brand names and all that stuff. I've got some Gore-Tex pants on, some thermal underwear, thermal shirt. I've got my Black Diamond trekking poles, stick pick I'm using. Brought my smaller cook kit just in case we want to sit down and have something to eat. River over there. Got my Garmin GPS going too, just in case we need it to get back. We'll come back in the spring when this is when it's warmer out and we get more time to monkey around trying to figure out exactly where this place is. I know it's on the edge of the pond, so I'm guessing that river, that's a pond, probably through the trees there. But we'll go up this way a little ways. I did notice that coming up here on the right hand side was all posted, the left hand side was state land. So I don't know if that changes past the gate or what. Okay, well I guess here we are, we found it. At least we found some of the outbuildings I've heard about. The battery's about to go, so I'm gonna have to pop in a new one here shortly. There's a, it's like a stable of some sort. Let me get out of the sun. There we go. Or a stable, maybe. Oh, there's freshly cut wood in there. It might be a good place to just get out of the wind for a second and switch this battery over. We'll see in a little bit. Alright, so I think we're back up and running. Got the battery changed and we're off. So I think, if I remember from when I've, there's very little literature out there about this place on the web anyway. So we're just gonna, I know there's a bunch of outbuildings before you approach the great camp. Yeah, so that connects over to this little shed. That looks fairly new there. Then we got an old greenhouse. And your hose. Your hose reel. It's an old tire rim. Yeah, the windows are all busted out of this. It's too bad. Alright, there's another building over here. truck tires. Somebody's been up here not too long ago. The road was kind of plowed, so. This is very easy to get to. That's probably the unfortunate part of the thing, because there's always somebody that wants to destroy things. It's unfortunate. Yeah, all right. There's another outbuilding, nice log cabin. I can see somebody's kind of tarped the roof, but it looks like it's been a while. Tarped on this side too. This is, I don't know if this is a storage shed of some sort. Yeah, it's all tarped. Don't stay out of there, buddy. Weird, a lot of it's held up really well. I don't know if somebody's done restoration work or if this is just, this part's just holding up. That's in really good shape in there. Yeah, I don't dare go in here. I don't know if you're supposed to or not, so. But that goes back inside. I can't see, it's so dark. There's blow down back here. Okay. Hey, Odin, where are you? Oh, okay. He snuck past me. Okay, wind's gonna pick up now, boy. I don't know if you apologize for the wind noise. Let's just go look at the other side of this thing. Looks like there's another little cabin up there. That addition's probably fairly recent. There's a little cabin back there. I don't think we saw. Wait in the middle there. Maybe we'll hit that on the way out. There's three more buildings that I can see. I assume these are all part of the great camp. This one's got propane tanks outside of it. Well, that's relatively new there. So hopefully that's a good sign. Hopefully somebody's, that's a power line going to it. So hopefully somebody's actively involved in saving this place. I want to look into that. Maybe I could help somehow. It's a really cool place. Now this must be part of the Great Camp, I'm guessing. The mountain in the background. I'm guessing that's Debar Mountain. My geography is terrible, so. But it would make sense this is Debar Pond. It makes sense that that's Debar Mountain, at least part of it somewhere around here. So, well, this has got security lights and. in really good shape. Power. There's a old trail sign. Follow trail to, can't make it out, but that's neat. So that must be the great camp back there. So it starts over here. This is a good size structure, prevent forest fires, I'm assuming. So yeah, all right, we'll walk around this way. That roof's in pretty good shape, from what I can tell. Little screen door. I don't know if we can see inside at all. There's some shingles off of the roof, but no. Well, I don't know. I don't know if you can see that or my reflection. Should have shaded it down. Was that all right? I'm gonna try going around from the other side and see if this will look in. But so there's the pond. Be a beautiful spot in spring to come up. Must be a cellar. This place, you know, the article I read made it sound like this was in bad shape, but you know, the windows all seem to be intact. Somebody did a lot of work. There's a little pen of some sort there. Interesting. Odin. Fire pit and a picnic table. I hear him jiggling around somewhere. There's the back side. This is the side that faces the lake. You know, it says no admittance on it, so I will not be going inside because I'm one of the people that likes to follow the rules. Oh, look at this. Rope swing. Got way up there. That is cool, off an old pine. So, that, yeah, boy, this is, must have been a place back in the day. Old stool sitting there. Good stonework on these steps. Beautiful place in there. Too bad they can't open it up to the public. That would be fantastic. I don't know if you can see in there or not. Back out. Boy, it looks like to me those look like air conditioning brackets. I wonder if somebody had air conditioning in here at one time. So this side has got a little situation going on with the roof, but there's a new chimney on there. There's some unit of some sort over here. The central AC, maybe? Heater of some sort? No idea. Yeah, another entrance to the basement. I don't know if I, wow, look at that, it's beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. I don't know if I showed that stone gate right there. That comes right to the center of the house. Keep tapping the screen to get my screen to come back up. Now there's an American flag out here. So here we are. I don't know if this is the main entrance or what, but there's a relatively new American flag out here. No admittance, private residence. Those signs have probably been around for a while. Old sled, runner sled. So it looks like somebody's been up here. Go down to the lake and then we're gonna head out. I think Odin's getting tired. Not too, pretty warm actually. My hands are a little cold because I just got some little fleece gloves on. But normally I would use my iPhone to film this stuff, but it's batteries all wonky and you get out in the cold and it goes from, you know, 50% charged to nothing in just seconds and shuts off. So, you know, the sun's gonna be right in our eyes here, but. Yeah, so you probably can kayak right into here, I would think. Probably some put-ins on Debar Pond. Pretty soggy down here. Well, the boat dock's a mess. But let's do a slow panorama. Debar Pond. Odin, don't go on the ice, buddy. It's the last thing I need, to try to pull him out of the ice. Been down that road once already. In his life. So I'm going to keep sweeping so you can see there's the house. Beautiful, beautiful. Yeah, old boathouse. Rake out there. So the signs of life here. The windows are all busted out of this. Life jackets and a chair with a towel on it. Kayaks. So somebody's up here. Alright, we're gonna head on back. Checking on Odin's whereabouts. So probably the main house was that big one, and then the one that's in front of it is the, well, depending on what your point of orientation, maybe servants' quarters or something. They don't get the view of the lake. You can imagine somebody rolling up here in a horse-drawn carriage. That must have been fun. Those hedges look fairly maintained. And there's the view of the stone entryway. Let me go back over here. Well, so that place is in better shape than I thought. And I don't think it would take a whole awful lot to keep it up and running. All those people stay away from it. Yeah, so maybe we'll come back up in the spring and check it out. Maybe bring Mom up here. She could make this walk pretty easy. Maybe bring the drone up. Get some aerials. windy now. This is all good practice for something I'd like to, I'm going to keep hinting at in my videos leading up to my big announcement. Hopefully sometime in March. Just got to get a couple more ducks in a row before I can go ahead and pull the trigger on it.
I think I got that operational. Right, so anyway, like I said, in March I hope to make an announcement about an upcoming thing. Sure, I guess I'll let out, but it's a pretty big deal, something I've been wanting to do for a long time. Things that might actually happen. I guess we're headed out, so that's the Debar Pond Lodge, former Great Camp, and I will link to any information I've got. There's not much. Please, people, if you come up here, I'm not going to post any directions or anything. Figure that out yourself. If you come up here, be respectful, man. Don't trash the place. Don't leave your garbage. Don't come up, enjoy it. This is history up here. Don't be one of those people. I haven't really used the selfie sticks a whole heck of a lot, so I'm not sure what my angle's like. If I should be here, up here. What? I got the stick pick on my trekking pole. Then I recently picked up my first down jacket. Again, I think I might need that on this thing I'm talking about. LL Bean happened to be down in Albany, New York, and there's an Albany. In Albany, there's a LL Bean, big LL Bean store. And I picked up a 850 hooded down jacket. So crazy light. I couldn't believe how light it was. And it folds up into its pocket, its own pocket. Taking it, I don't know if I made videos with it on or not. This is my good old North Face Summit series. I don't know what the exact model of this coat is, but it's the one that Odin looked the sleeve on. And I got has a zip in fleece. And I don't know, I wear this all the time up here. It's my winter jacket. And, I've never really been cold with it on, so. I'll mention when I get back. I got a bunch of crap in my pack that I brought. A little fold-up chair, some food, and I got water back there. A bunch of stuff. But I want to weigh that and see how much weight I was carrying. And I got Odin's bowl and some water, dog treats. And I also, in addition, I'm wearing my Solomon boots. GT X4D something on it. I don't know. I'll put all that in there. Then I tried those Njinji socks that I got, toe socks that I got from Karen. I got one of those on my right foot with a darn tough hiking sock, and then I just got my regular darn tough hiking sock on the left foot. So I kind of wanted to see what the difference would be. My feet feel a little cramped. That could be my laces are too tight. I do notice these boots have a little bit of a slippage because my feet are, depending on how a manufacturer sizes their boot, I'm usually right at the tail end of a men's size. So I forget these Solomons I sent back and forth to Amazon almost three times. I think I had eights and those were too big. And I got 7.5s. And sevens, and I don't know if I sent the sevens back and kept the 7.5. I can't remember what size these are. But it's such a buying boots over the internet's not a good idea. So I'm gonna need a new pair for this other thing. And I think I'm gonna go to EMS in Lake Placid, or there's a place called the Mountaineer out in Keene Valley. Awesome little store. The prices aren't they're expensive, but it's a little store that caters out there to the climbing and ice climbing crowd and whatnot. So they have some real knowledgeable staff out there, so I think I'll maybe go out there and just get them to properly fit me for a shoe. I mean, really, because my feet hurt all the time anyway. kind of rambling on, but I'm trying to keep myself busy and warm and whatnot. All right, so we're going to go around the park. I had to figure that out. I got through. How'd you get through, buddy? Come around here. Come around here, buddy. There you go. That's a good boy. All right, so, really, the only feet that my shoes, that my feet are comfortable wearing at the time are a pair of Crocs. And not so much these new Crocs. These my original pair of Crocs was a much more pliable material. And I actually wore holes through them. The ball of my foot wore a hole right through them, both sides, in a couple of pairs, because I wore them so much. People make fun of them, but man, they were comfortable. Then I got these new pairs, and not only did they change the sizing on them, so I had to monkey around with that, they changed the material. It's a much harder material, not as comfortable, but they still work. All right, so we are, this is all I see here. Back at the car, so I'm gonna have to help Odin get in, because he's gonna be 12 here in a couple weeks, and it's a hard time getting out of the car. So that was the Debar Pond Lodge in Debar Lake, Debar Pond, I should say. So thanks for watching, everybody, and we'll see you again real soon.